Another place that we can look at the use of pronouns and function words is trying to detect honesty versus deception. A question that I asked several years ago with some of my students, is it possible to come up with essentially a linguistic lie detector? So what we did is we brought people in the laboratory and we induced them to either tell the truth or lie. And so someone would come in and we had asked them to steal a dollar. Half the people weren't given the opportunity, the other half took the opportunity. And someone came in and says, this dollar's not here, did you steal it? And everybody was instructed to say no. Now some of those people were telling the truth and some were lying. Then we would take them back and essentially interrogate them. What we found was that when people are telling the truth, there's a really different language profile than when they're lying. And one way that you can tell if people are telling the truth, they use the word I more. They use more complex language, a group of words that we call exclusive words. These are conjunctions and prepositions. These are words like except, without, but, exclude. You're making a distinction between what is in a category and what's not in the category. And that's actually kind of complex. So if I'm to say, well, I went yesterday to see my brother, except on the way there, I realized I didn't do this, so instead, but, except, and so forth. I'm making these distinctions between what I did do and didn't do. If I'm lying, that's way too complex to tell you what I didn't do or what I wasn't thinking about. And so people who are liars tend to not use the word I. They're psychologically distancing themselves. And they're also not using these markers of complexity. And what we found is that across now, there have been a large number of studies, our labs and others, show that we do much better than chance at detecting lies. It's not 100% by any means, but it's better than humans, 67% accuracy compared to 50%, which would be chance.